sino host?
Birdie.
Sino, ito sir,
JR.
Ang siyang host.
Hello.
So nagtataka, may nagtataka po kung bakit hindi nakasuot ang ating sash ang dalawang candidates for now. This is the special announcement that we need for this afternoon, especially for the media and for everyone watching at home. We are now announcing that Mr. NCR, Mr. Cimentage NCR will be awarded to our Quezon City candidate, Ms.
Wait. Isa pa po, ulit pa ulit po yung pag-ano.
Ay, sorry.
Ceremonial.
Ceremonial.
Hindi, yung ano na, nakatapos awa ko.
Awa ka mo lang.
Thank you. Peter, dito na lang ano.
Sa gitna na.
Kuya, sa gitna.
Sa gitna kayong dalawa.
Isa pa.
Yeah, thank you. Yes.
Kasi hindi namin ako.
Tapos kamingin ka din dito, Soya. Huwag ka, ano.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. Madami sir yan. Madami magpipicture. Wait lang. Madami yan sir.
Here.
Oo, yun. Please sa likod.
Sir, dito pa.
Okay.
Sir, right. Dito sir.
Okay naman.
Okay.
Dito.
So, ito, she will now be crowned by our National Director, Mr.
Si Peter muna. Peter and Melvin. Okay.
Okay, sir, dito forward ka ng konti para kita yung face mo.
Yeah! Sir, dito, sir!
Sabi ni Lito.
Thank you.
Hello, okay. Next na announcement po natin. So, what here comes Miss Teresa Meritage San Mateo. The previous Miss Teresa Meritage NCR. She will now be crowned. As our Mr. Cimentage, Greater Manila area.
My name
is GMA.
Peter muna. Dr. Peter Fe, MD.
And then the crowd.
Wait, sorry.
Wait,
there's more.
There's more. Okay,
naman. One, two, three.
Dito naman sa amin ni Lito. Okay.
So now she will also be crowned by Sir Michael.
Talikot ulit, sir.
Kunyari, sir.
Talikot, sir.
Forward ka ng konti, ano.
Yan. Sa likot.
Sige, sir. Tumingin ka dun sa amin.
Ayan. Ayan. Kadalas mo ulit, sir.
Parang ano, Patriona,
ano. Sir, dito po.
Very late.
Sir, dito naman, sir.
Here. So again, thank you everyone, our media partners, and we do apologize for doon sa sudden change, pero that's why we presented all of the new candidate for Miss our winner for Miss Tourism Education NCR. And the new title of our Mr. Cimentage NCR. So here they are, our queens for Mr. Cimentage National Pageant.
Bawat isa magpakilala lang.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Ay, joke ka na lang.
Oo, tell us about yours.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Hannah Althea Abian. I am History of the Heritage Mindanao.
And then, all right. And then this.
Good day, everyone. I am Princess Andrea Paraiso Bajaj, and I am your Miss Tourism Heritage Luzon.
And then we have Miss Accord. Ay, yung ano muna siguro, yung Miss Tourism. Yes, okay na girl, thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Queen Jubilee Mungkupa, 22 years old. I'm your Miss Tourism Heritage NCR.
Queen here.
NCR here.
Queen.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Caitlin Silan Bicho from San Mateo Rizal, your newly crowned Miss Tourism Heritage Greater Manila.
She will be our Miss Tourism Heritage winner for the national event. She will represent Philippines in our incoming international event, which will be held later this year. So please support Miss Carolina, Miss Tourism Heritage Philippines candidate. And she will be supported also and backed up by our other winners. And we will be they will be joining us through our until our international event. So, please expect all of them to be there.
Thank you. Ayan. So, kumusta naman kay girls?
Yes.
How are you after your formation? Let's start siguro with Miss Teresa.
So, I think maybe hindi pa rin siya nagsisikin na nanalo ako kasi wasn't expecting talaga na makapagbili niya ako sa top 10. But yeah, I'm very grateful and beyond blessed kasi ayun nga, may corona sa akin. You know what, guys? Up until now, it's so surreal that I won the title of Miss Tourism Luzon. And there's a lot of opportunities. And I thank God that He allowed me in this position. And you know what? Aside from that, I'm very thankful that I had a best friend, which is, you know, and Quezon City, and I'm very grateful to them.
Paano naman si ano, Sambuanga?
Di ba?
Kasi,
Mateo.
Hindi siya
masaya.
Ano ba
yung
thing is for sure, I am very grateful because I get to share this parade, this crowd, together with my girls. I'm so happy and I hope, I wish myself luck for this incoming international pageant. Supportahan niyo po ako. Maraming salamat po. To be honest, I have received both positive and negative reviews regarding my title. But now I, you know, at least I'm having this kind of security na yung title ko. So I think this will be a greater opportunity for the both for the rest of the girls. So, sa mga winners ngayon, thank you so much. They consider me as their
winner. May question ako sa brand winner. Yes. As Miss Tourism Heritage, ano yung duties and responsibilities?
Actually, for me po, the real duty is to promote tourism with actions. Given na po na andyan yung social media, it's the best way for me to use to promote our tourism, to preserve our heritage. And at the same time, malaki po talaga yung responsibility. Alam ko na po yun ahead of time eh. Yung crown kasi, it's not just, to win the crown for that night. Ayun na yun. But I have to prepare myself and I'm lucky enough na I embraced myself. I already prepared so much for this responsibility. And I believe, together with my girls beside me, they will help me. Together, we will work hard to promote the vision and mission of this pageant. Yun lang po. Maraming salamat.
Girls, aside from your regular duties and responsibilities to the organization as the inaugural winner of Miss Heritage for 2022, how would you like to, what is your plan? How would you like to spend your 1 year reign as winners?
Actually, I do have a plan coordinating with the tourism management. And of course, in our local government, I would give a help to them. And of course, I can't do it by myself, so I need their cooperation.
Yeah. Actually, for me po, I have a lot of plans. Aside from the international pageant, since hindi naman po siguro pa dapat ako mag-prepare talaga doon. Ahead of my plans, I would like to really promote the sa fashion industry, yung mga textiles, yung mga local textiles, lalo na po sa part ko. I am from Zamboanga City and we have this Yaman textiles. I actually, sinuot ko po siya one of my outfits during our Miss Tourism Heritage Journey. And para po sa akin, isa na po siyang malaking ground for us to use the local fabrics that we have here in the Philippines. And yun na nga po, given na we are in the pageant industry, connected po siya sa fashion industry. So, malaking ground na po po para sa atin na ipupuko yung mga local textiles natin.
Winner, grand winner.
Yes.
How did winning Miss Miss Grand Tulay? Miss winning Miss Tourism Heritage changed you?
To be honest, hindi pa po kasi ako masyadong na-compose. Mm-hmm. But winning this crown, it made me realize na I deserve this. Na I have this capability na which nag-push sa akin na yes, I am the chosen one. I deserve this crown. And one thing is for sure, the only thing na kailangan ko gawin is to prove the people na deserve ko po tong crown na hindi ko po isasayangin yung reign ko.
And of course, you're going to compete na international, no?
Yes.
Of this November daw. So ano yung mga strategy mo ngayon? Na, of course, may mga game plan. Can you share as you play game plan for international pageant?
We didn't talk about it pa po, honestly. But for me, siguro, we will work hard for it. I know that the heads of this national pageant will really help me. And siguro para po sa akin, I have to prepare myself as early as now, as early as possible.
Ikaw kung gusto pa muna yung sarili ko. Eh, kung sarili yung matagal sa buwan, o yung mga press.
They are so happy po. Yun lang po yung napin ko. Actually, right after the pageant, yung naramdaman ko po, yung saya, yung love.
Na kahit yun, malayo sila.
Yes po. Actually, may live po pala that time. And nakikita ko po na actually halos lahat po ng mga
tao,
ang lakas po nilang mag-cheer. And kaya nga po, kahit ang layo ko po sa kanila, napipil ko po na dala-dala ko po yung buong Zamboanga City sa akin, sa stage. Kaya maraming salamat po sa mga Zamboangueños. Actually, sa mga tao na, na bumubuo ng Zamboanga Peninsula, lahat po kasi sila eh, not just Zamboanga City. Shoutout po pala sa Zamboanga del Norte kasi hindi po ako hindi po, po dapat nire-represent yung Zamboanga City. I actually dapat nire-represent yung Zamboanga del Norte because I first won there. My first national pageant was Miss Labasan Tourism. And that moment po, dun po pa po na-realize na I have this capability, I have this strength na kaya ko pong mag-promote ng tourism natin. Kaya po ni-pursue ko po yung Miss Tourism Heritage.
Is that...
Sige po!
Okay. What particular tourism heritage of Zamboanga would you like to showcase pag nag-compete ka rin internationally?
You know, we have this, kumbaga kung sa Manila, we have this Fort Santiago. But in Zamboanga, we have this Fort Pilar Shrine. It's a shrine commemorated to Nuestra Señora la Virgen del Pilar. You know, Zamboanga City kasi, it's a place where natural culture and heritage are still well preserved. You know, we have this language na Chabacano. Yes, it's a broken Spanish. And Zamboanga City, aside from that, is mixed with culture. We have this Yakan people there. We have Muslim brothers and sisters, Bisaya people, and of course, us Zamboangueños. And the Fort Pilar Shrine po, even Muslim brothers and sisters, they visit there. They pray there. And that is something that is unique with Zamboanga City. We value this beauty of diversity, and Fort Pilar serves as our driving force for peace. Because there in our city, we live together harmoniously, despite of the different cultures and traditions that we have there. Kaya if you will, you will plan to visit Zamboanga City, I will first bring you to Fort Pilar Shrine.
Is there a plan for your homecoming before for winning the title?
Yes po, they are actually asking me if kailan po ako babalik ng Zamboanga and hindi pa po kasi siya masyadong fixed. Pero this coming May 5 po, uwi po ako ng Zamboanga City and they are actually planning to welcome me there po to a motorcade. Kaya maraming salamat.
Abangan naman yung sila yung Miss Tourism.
How about kay Miss Tourism, Mindanao and Siluson? Is there parang message from your LGU na congratulating you and asking you when are you going home?
Yeah, actually, nag-coordinate ko sa amin yung head of tourism office namin and nagtatanong din siya kung kailan ako uuwi. Probably, sa guest na ng city namin on May 22, I'll be going to Mindanao and meron po kami grand motorcade na nagsasama ko.
Saan po sa Mindanao?
Tingoong City po. Nizamis Oriental. Yes, actually yung city namin is Bishanon. Pero just so you know, our city is in between Butuan City and Cagayan de Oro.
Ano mang kapital ng Nizamis?
Sorry?
Ano ang capital of Misamis?
Cagayan de Oro.
Anyway, Miss Quezon City, of course, that night, the coronation night, wala kang title ng time yun, night na yun. So, kamo sa'yo feeling na, oh my God, you're proud na as Miss Tourism Heritage. NCR. Sino pa kalaban mo noon? I mean, sa NCR. Si Miss Patrick lang, talaga ikaw yung napili. So, ano ba? Kamusta yung pangaram na?
I'm okay. Sobrang saya ko po talaga. Kasi paid off na lahat ng yung hirap ko. Kumbaga worth it lahat ng sleepless night ko sa pag-prepare to.
Kailan ko siya nabalitaan na ika-crown ka today? 2 days ago or ano ba?
Last week.
Ah, last week pa.
Yes. Nakausap yung city director ko na yun nga po na
ikaw talaga yung but of course yung ating ex-Miss NCR and now you are Miss Greater Manila. So kumusta naman na you're greater, you're representing the Greater Manila, hindi lang siya NCR.
Kaya nang sabi ko kanina, I received positive and negative feedbacks. Kasi geographically speaking, hindi naman talaga San Mateo. But I'm still happy na consider pa rin ako ng organization.
Of course naman.
Of course. Ng crowd, diba? Or hindi ako palitan basta-basta.
And sabi mo nga, sige lang.
Yes, thankful pa din na I still have a place with the girls.
And sabi mo nga may mga criticism, may mga bashers. So, paano mo hinahandle yung mga online bashers na ganyan?
Nakabiyo ko po talaga siya.
Ano no?
Nakabiyo ko siya, hindi naman talaga naiiwasan. And ang dami din talagang comments na nakatype sa Mateo, San Mateo. So, at first, nalungkot ako na sa ganung way pa naging sikat yung bayan ko. So, ngayon medyo happy na ako na Ito na, meron na tayong
wala nang babash yung mga bashers
So how do you deal with bashers pala?
Yeah, oo, sa inyong lahat.
Sa inyong lahat. Yeah, start.
On behalf of my sisters, the best, siguro for me, the best way to handle the bashers is to prove them wrong. To smile in front of them. Because, hindi naman kami magiging, para sa akin po ha, hindi naman po tayo, for me, hindi po kasi ako, hindi ko kinoconsider yung self ko na successful if I don't have bashers. Kasi they're inevitable. So the best way to handle them is to prove them wrong. For me, wala pong pang-bashers. I'm the unbothered queen.
Wow! Unbothered? Parang katoni ko sa akin. Nakakatoni ko sa
akin.
The best lesson learned from you during the interview.
The biggest lesson that I learned is we have to value the difference of our culture. Because we could, for me, we couldn't be able to promote the beauty of the Philippines, the beauty of our tourism and heritage. If tayo po mismo, hindi po natin pinapahalagan yung differences ng mga kultura at traditions na meron po tayo sa iba't ibang sulok ng Pilipinas.
Ay, ano ba yung lesson na yun na na-learn mo na, hindi ba, sabi mo nga, iba yung culture natin, ano ba yung, can you share one thing na na-prove mo na iba-iba talaga yung culture natin?
Kami po kasi sa batch po namin, though we are so busy with our schedules na nagpupuyat po talaga kami, but at the end of the day, kami po, actually kami po lima, nag-ano po kami, nagbaban po kami sa isang room to erase our stress, to erase our mga kapaguran namin. And sa mga constant chicas namin po, nadi-differentiate po talaga namin. Example, ako po from Zamboanga City, my language alone is very different from Tagalog. It's very different from Bisaya. And yun nga po, in general, nakikita sa casual talking po namin, nakikita po kasi yung differences. Lalo na po sa mga, paano ba to? Sa mga instances po talaga, sa lahat ng instances, nakikita po talaga yung difference. And yung maganda po sa amin, nakakabuo po kami ng friendship out of this differences.
In your religious country, do you have any religious beginning?
Now, you make me have a question, ka?
Question. Do you have a religious background? Which religion?
I am actually a Roman Catholic.
Roman Catholic, okay. Yung iba?
Roman Catholic.
I'm Iglesia
Ni Cristo. Roman Catholic.
Roman Catholic.
I'm also Roman Catholic.
Oh, very good.
Mutante na pa kayo. Mutante na kayo na.
Yes.
Wow.
May po rin sa Catholic po ba?
Oh, iwasan natin yung palette.
Yes!
Alam, tanda na
rin. Nagulat po ako eh.
Kaya rasta man tayo.
For rasta, for president.
Para walang issue.
Iwasan natin yung
ganyan. Politics. Pero siguro ano, maybe you could ask.
Yes, final message nila or kung gusto nyo pasalamatan throughout your journey. And then, of course, message na lang.
Yes. Start that in singing ko.
Yes. Okay. So first and foremost, I would like to thank those who supported me throughout this pageant, most especially my fellow Ikaw-Ikaw-Nuns. Yeah, and I can't wait to see you all there when I get back to Mindanao. And once again, I thank you very much from the very bottom of my heart. Thank you so much.
NCR.
I would like to thank for Quezon City, yung mahal kong batch. And of course, my family, yung friend Alabado family, my designer, James Paul, and Dave Ordonio, and my CD director, James Puglia. Thank you so much for unending support. Thank you so much. For me, I would like to thank to all of those people who supported me, especially the BPDC, my camp, Nymeg, my friends and family who very supported me in the beginning. And they're always there for me to motivate me, because during the pageant, honestly, I had a mental breakdown, and they are the ones who supported me, motivate me, and believe me when I am doubting myself.
And the grand winner, yan.
Actually, pray, nagpa-pray po ako na sana pumapasalamatan ko lahat-lahat eh. Ang dami po kasi talaga. But to start, I wanna thank the ALS Life Support Center for supporting me, for being my backbone during this journey. My family, of course. Paano pa to? The Zamboanga City, mga Zamboangueños, maraming salamat po. Gusto ko pong sabihin na nararamdaman ko po lahat ng pagmamahal nyo, lahat ng suporta nyo sa akin, and I'm very thankful. Thankful po ako para sa inyo. And of course, my Labasong Tourism family, maraming salamat po. I wouldn't be here if hindi po dahil sa inyo, sa friends ko, sa mga taong sumusuporta po sa akin. Maraming salamat po. Hindi ko man po kayo mag-isa-isa, pero God knows how much I'm thankful for all of you. Maraming salamat po.
Gitna muna.
Princess